议员，我哋问紧即系政策上嘅问题嘅，你有冇
？Dr. Kwok, we are deliberating on policy issues. Do you have any questions?Chairman, I do have questions. Well, I suspended the meeting because there was no member present. So I would give you a minute to look at the paper.
主席，你預計呢個會
？Chairman, do you expect to wrap up by the day? All right, thank you.For the two-tiered profits tax rates regime, it was implemented in 2018 to 19. For the first $2 million of assessable profits, the tax rates were slashed by half. So these amounted to tax reductions. So why are they granting the profits tax waivers every year? Is this a case of double benefits? Are we being too generous to businesses? Mr. Lai, thank you very much. The two-tiered profits tax rates regime was implemented in 2018 to 19. So for the first $2 million of assessable profits, businesses can enjoy a lower tax rate of 8.25%. Mr. Kwok's concern or question is whether we should still grant these businesses tax concession. We considered the issue and we felt that there are three reasons justifying the measure. First, according to the financial budget in his financial secretary in his budget announcement this year, with the external uncertainties, we want to do more to support our businesses. So if profits tax deductions can help the business, we are happy to help. Number two,for companies that need to pay profits tax, they can enjoy a maximum deduction of $20,000. So since we have a surplus north of $16 billion, we are happy to share the wealth with the people and businesses. For past one-off reductions, such as salaries tax and profits tax, over the years, these have always gone hand in hand. In terms of the financial implications, even though the government will forgo $18.9 billion of one-off revenue, but only $1.9 billion would be due to the profit tax waivers.So we find it appropriate to benefit both individual taxpayers and businesses. Mr. Lai said they considered the issue when they decided on the measure, but with the constant concessions, there is a problem. We do not have a two-tiered salaries tax rate, and the salary earners only enjoy a maximum deduction of $20,000. So why is the government benefiting the companies more? The initial announced surplus was about $50 billion, and last week,the government said the surplus will be close to $100 billion. So the difference is more than $40 billion. So is there any room to amend the coming budget? So everyone would wonder where the $40 billion will end up. For the sweeteners, you dish out 75% of the $50 billion surplus. So will the financial secretary announce further sweeteners? The FTU feels that the sweeteners for the current budget are not enough. Mr. Lai, please address the question on the salaries tax rate first. I understand Mr. Kwok's argument, but to be fair, for past years, we offered concessions in salaries tax. For example, last year, we expanded the separation of the tax bands from $45,000 to $50,000, and the families or households with medium income will pay less taxes. So we are still offering the one-off concessions by adopting the same standards.
No, but then the level is a lot different. Well, you are talking about widening the tax band and also the two-tier tax structure. Well, please continue. Mr. Kwok just talked about the 2018-19 fiscal year, which just ended last week. So he referred to the final estimates. When FS announced the latest budget concerning 2018-19 government surplus, the FS had made an adjustment or revision. It is expected that the surplus was 58.7 billion, and this was up to end of March. This is, in fact, the latest and the most realistic estimate. Just now, Mr. Kwok also raised a point. It is true that the government wants to enhance transparency of public finance. So every month, we announced the actual expenses and revenue as of month end and the surplus at that moment. At the end of March, when we made this regular announcement, we said that for 2018-19 fiscal year up to the end of February, there was a surplus of almost 100 billion. This is a fact. But please don't forget that we hadn't completed our accounts in March. So as of the end of April, then we will have the full set of figures for 2018-19. If at the end of February there was a surplus of 100 billion, it won't be all of a sudden reduced by a few 10 billion. So we will know at the end of this month. For profits tax and salaries tax, usually all was paid already in August, September, and there won't be much new tax revenue. And then for sale of land, those that should be accounted for had already been done so. However, for expenses, usually in the last 1 to 2 months, expenses would be usually bigger than normal. So we still believe that 58.7 billion is the best estimate of our surplus for 2018-19. Mr. Kwok, in that case, I don't know how to ask further questions. Well, they maintain the same estimate, even though there is a big discrepancy. So, okay, let's wait till the figures for March are released. I think by then, the figure will be very different. Mr. Wong Ting Kwong, thank you, Chairman. Now, we are scrutinizing the Inland Revenue Amendment Tax Concessions Bill 2019. When it comes to annual revenue, it should be discussed in the FC and panel. So I think chairman and officials should put a limit to the scope of questions raised by members or colleagues. I think financial management and expenses are in the responsibility of the FS. So if you talk about spending public funds to increase concessions or relief for residents, well, I think it is not for us to talk about. It is against basic law. We can only reduce but not increase. We can only reduce expenses. So perhaps you can propose certain cuts in the expenses, but you cannot propose increase in government's expenditure. Besides, regarding tax concessions, as usual, in many previous years, there were these measures. It's just that the numbers were different. So relatively speaking, this bill should be more straightforward. I hope that it can be handled as soon as possible. There are so many matters to deal with for LegCo. So see, members of this committee are engaged in three different meetings held at the same time. I was working in as the establishment subcommittee just now, and I was asked to join this meeting just now. Now, I think this bill should not be controversial relative to the bill about rates. To a certain extent, more people can benefit from this bill. Residents may not have properties that are rateable, but for the middle class, their salaries tax burden can be reduced. We are not saying that we want to distribute money to them. We just want them to be able to pay less. So I think DAB will surely support this bill. And chairman and government, I hope you can complete your work as soon as possible so that we can start other work. Because this bill is relatively simple. Thank you, chairman. Do you want any response from the government? No? Well, I just expressed my views. Right. Thank you, Mr. Wong, for your understanding and support. Thank you. Mr. Kwok Wai Kong, Dr. KK Kwok, any questions? Yes, both of you are Mr. Kwok. Kwok Wai Kong, thank you, Chairman. Mr. Wong Ting Kwong has his views, but Chairman, upper limit is 75% and 20,000 in terms of the tax concessions. If this is said that in the future, if the government wants to offer more benefit, then it cannot do it by means of the tax system. They can only make use of other avenues. In the past, before a vote is taken, usually these bills would be dealt with. This time, can we avoid working backward in the future? So is it possible to vote on the overall budget first before voting on these bills? Mr. Kwok, referring to the voting arrangement, in May, we will start working on the appropriation bill, and then in the end of May and mid-June, the vote should be completed. And this one should be after that, for second and third reading. So even after we have completed the Bills Committee procedures, the resumption of second and third reading will take place after the appropriation bill. So you should have enough time to move amendments if you want, and the government should have time to also make other adjustments if necessary. But at this moment, the Deputy Secretary has not received any instruction from FS about possible amendments. So are we just working according to established procedure? Well, you may not put it that way, because from now till second and third reading of this bill, there is still some time. If the government wants to move CSA, if there is any, then we have to convene a meeting to scrutinize the CSAs in order to be responsible. So we still have the chance to review this bill. So I can say to you that this is possible. Okay, so Chairman, we should just work on things that we have now as much as we can. But I think so. Let's express our opinions first, and if necessary, adjustments can be made. So we don't need to add anything in other bills, so we can consider more about the tax regime. Next, Dr. KK Kwok. We have asked so many questions in order to help people in difficulty. Chairman, I want to focus on the salaries tax. So there will be a reduction of 17 billion. Many taxpayers will be able to benefit. This year, many industries may not be able to benefit. They may incur big loss. I have heard a lot of news. For instance, the property agents, the sales representatives encountered big difficulty this year. And there is a large number of these salespeople, and they may not be able to enjoy such concession. For example, they may have to support two children, they may have to pay mortgage or rent. So they may not be able to enjoy any benefit. So I always said to the FS that enough support should be given to these people. Of course, if a person is so lucky that he can earn up to 20,000 salaries tax, then I should congratulate him. But for those who are not able to pay salaries tax after all the expenses are deducted or after all the allowances are deducted, then they will see a red line. So what kind of help will the government give them? They may be along the borderline. They may not be able to get the 4,000. So they can't get 4,000 from you, and they can't enjoy the tax concession. How are you going to help these people? This is a question about policies. Right. Any figures in relation to the borderline cases? Mr. Lai? Chairman, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Kwok. Our tax system and tax base are simple and low. If you talk about salaries tax, now we have a workforce of 4 million people, but only 1.9 million odd people need to pay salaries tax. In other words, Dr. Kwok's understanding is right. We are providing tax concessions, so you can only benefit if you need to pay salaries tax. Now, Dr. Kwok may be concerned there are around 2 million people in the labor force. If they do not pay, or if they do not need to pay salaries tax, isn't it true that they can't benefit? I will not adopt this perspective. There are two reasons. First, salaries taxes in Hong Kong are quite loose. There are different types of allowances. This year, there is a new allowance. That is, if you buy voluntary medical insurance, or if you make voluntary contribution to MPF, or if you buy annuity plans, then the contribution will be tax deductible. So income has not been reduced, but it's just that there are other tax allowances or widening of the tax band so that some people can pay less or don't need to pay salaries tax. For very low income earning families, if they can't enjoy any tax concessions, then in the FS budget, there are other measures to help these low-income families. If you look at this year's budget, as in the past, for CSSA families and recipients, there is an additional 1 month's allowance for them. So for the needy families, this is already a relief. There are other more targeted or specific measures. So in the coming year, for those DSE candidates, the exam fee will be paid by the government.
For students taking the DSE this year, we introduced the same measure in the last budget. So all in all, we offer assistance to different people. For a four-person household, under the current salaries tax regime, so for a four-person household, how much would they have to make before they start paying taxes? Can Deputy Commissioner or Deputy Secretary answer the question? Let's assume this four-person household has a couple and two children. The allowance for a couple is 264,000, while the child allowance is 100,000 each. So if the couple makes $500,000 per year, they would not have to pay taxes. If they have dependent parents or other deductions or allowances, the threshold is even higher. How about, can you explain the progressive salaries tax rates? Last year, we amended the tax bands for salaries tax. In the past, the tax bands were $45,000 apart. Starting from 2018 to 2019, the separation became $50,000. The marginal tax rates used to be 2, 7, 12, and 17%. And with five tax bands, we have expanded the margins to 2, 6, 10, 14, and 17%. So assuming the same income with the expanded tax bands and marginal tax rates, the taxpayers will pay less. Dr. Kwok. I mentioned households who could pay salaries taxes. For example, last year they might be paying taxes, while a lot of people do not have fixed income. For example, agents, they might have to fend for their families. They might need to repay mortgage. So for such people who have paid taxes, can you rebate that specific portion to them, akin to profit tax? So apart from supporting people and businesses who are able, should you also help people without the means? Do you have any plans? You talked about funds or schemes for micro SMEs. So for these people, how for these taxpayers, how can you help them? These are people who live on commissions. We agree that we should help low-income families, as Dr. Kwok suggested, but just like profits tax, if certain payers of salaries tax paid taxes in the last few years, and in fact they benefited from our one-off concessions, last year the ceiling was $30,000, and in the 2 years prior, $20,000. So taxpayers should have benefited already. We understand that circumstances might change. So for households whose income plummeted, working family allowance, etc., they can help these low-income households. Well, Mr. Lai, you might not know that the threshold for various assistance such as CSSA is extremely high. So the basic salary is very low for these people, and they might make a lot less in commissions, and they are not eligible for any of the subsidies you mentioned. The textbook assistance might not be helpful to them, so they might have to suffer another year. I think you can consider offering rebate for 1 year for one of the previous years. So I wonder if the IRD can furnish any figures. And in your tax assessment, you can see that these people are making a lot less. They cannot benefit from the salaries tax deductions, and their incomes are dropping. If policy support is offered, around how much would you have to spend? So can you set a cap for rebate at $10,000 or something to that effect? After the meeting, we would provide a written response to Dr. Kwok's question. Like Mr. Wong Teng Kwong said, this bill is straightforward, and the aim is to offer one-off reductions. If we are to incorporate previous years of assessment, it would be legally complicated, and there are also concerns in our financial implications. For profits tax and salaries tax, the government will never give us accurate figures, because they are based on forecasts. So the there would be no way to know. Mr. Kwok, Dr. Kwok, and Mr. Wong Teng Kwong spoke today. If there's anything we can adjust for the 2018 to 2019 financial year, we shall see what we can do. I think it also depends on the financial position at the end of March. But as a medium to long-term measure, we hope the government would consider the views of different members today. Thank you very much for the summary. I agree, because they can still amend their policies. So for the two categories I mentioned, you can look up some figures. They used to pay profits tax or salaries tax, but since the situation is very difficult for them this year, well, I think you should first help this small group of people. And you are foregoing $18.9 billion of profit, and this is just like a sugar. This is just the cherry on the cake for them. If the government can support this small group of people, then they will find it very helpful. I think it's ridiculous that businesses who make $2 million of profit can enjoy a $20,000 deduction. Please convey the views of members to the Bureau and offer a written response as soon as possible. If we have no other business, we enter the clause by clause of the Blue Bill. Who can take us through the bill? Mr. Chiu, Deputy Commissioner. Thank you. Today we are looking at the Inland Revenue Amendment Tax Concessions Bill 2019. The bill serves to amend the IRO to give effect to a proposal concerning the tax deductions, concessions in the budget introduced for the 2019 to 20 financial year. So I will take you through the marked up copy, page 0001. And there are changes to the text to section 14 of the IRO, and in subsection 5, 14B2A is repealed to be replaced by 14B brackets 2 brackets B. And this corresponds to changes in the IRO, page 0002, section 100 of the IRO, and in subsection 2A, 14 brackets 2 to brackets 5 as well as 14AAC are added. So these are the provisions to be considered in the reduction of taxes. Page 0003, no changes. 0004, this is a new Annex 43 or Schedule 43 would be added. So this is the amendment bill. Any further questions? Any questions from the legal advisor? No. I have no further questions. So the scrutiny of the bill is complete. Thank you very much. Resumption of the second reading. There are a few suggested dates. So it depends on the progress of the council meetings. Two dates are proposed. First, 15th of May 2019 or the 22nd of May 2019. When you have decided on a date, please get in touch with the Secretariat and we would tell you the deadlines for amendments. So please inform the Secretariat as soon as possible. There should be time slots on both the 15th and 22nd of May for the resumption of second reading and third reading. Any other business? There will be no public hearing because the bill is straightforward. We will still collect public views on our website. So this is a standard practice. If you have decided on the date of the resumption of second reading, please inform the clerk as soon as possible. Thank you. The meeting's adjourned. Thank you.